A new face in Pericles' abode! Ha! That in itself is a remarkable thing. You must have seen me doing my impression of Cleon. I call it the Orange Ape. Tell me, what does it think?
I am called many things. It isn't one of them.
What do you call yourself then? Creature of many names?
Cassandra.
I wouldn't peg you as a Cassandra, but never mind. I'm Aristophanes, and this man is Euripides. Oh, go on, introduce yourself.
I'm Euripides.
For a playwright, you're not much for words.
Good men lead quiet lives, as old Euripides likes to say. Don't you, Euripides? Now, if you'll excuse us, I was just about to dazzle this old dog with my impression of Pericles. I call it the wooden board.
The man is your host.
Under every stone hides a politician, I always say. And Pericles is no different.
I suppose you've come in here to mock me for my fight with Euripides.
Spare me. I'm only looking for clues to help me find a Spartan woman.
A Spartan woman in Athens. Sounds intriguing. Though, if you expect me to notice someone other than myself, you expect too much. You could talk to Euripides. He's the second most worldly man here. That pediculous, Xanthodontus exothalmic Morosov. But he doesn't talk without a drink.
I have no idea what that meant.
No, you don't.
So we get him drunk and he talks. He sounds more Argive than Athenian.
Impressive foreigner. Euripides is from Argos.
All right. If nothing else, this party could use the help.
You'll need to pick the right wine for this task. The kitchen should have what you need. Let me know when Euripides is done in, and I'll slip away unseen.
How do you know Pericles?
I believe you mean to ask me, how does Pericles know you? I'm the greatest dramatist in the land, mentor to Euripides, lover of Asclepios, father of theater, and so on, and so on.
I'm sure it's a real honor to have you hiding in his kitchen. You're awfully worked up over Euripides. You sure you're just friends?
I'm never just anything, foreigner. Though I confess, Euripides and I hold a bond deeper than brotherhood. Why he slams it with a banal young plaything, Aristophanes, I will never know.
I'll get the wine.
Wonderful. Now, if you want some friendly advice, Aristophanes cannot stand sweet wine. I've seen what it can do to him. Absolutely, horrifyingly delightful.
It wouldn't be a party without someone losing their stomach. I'll let you know if your plan worked.
Save for that arrogant playwright. I don't see many distinguished guests in here. Can I help you with something?
I'm here for your sweet wine.
Yes, take it. But get out of my kitchen. I'm very busy, you know.
It's come back for more! Care to see my impression of Protagoras? I call it the flapping bladder.
I'm sure she wouldn't.
When I need to relax, I start a fight. For you, though.
Quickly! Bring him some wine so that he might say something clever.
After my argument with Sophocles, I think I'd rather keep my head clear.
I'm only here because I'm searching for someone.
And yet it gave us the distinct impression it was here to fill our wine. Let's focus on that first, shall we?
I'm Pericles' new servant. I'd be happy to bring some wine.
An Athenian servant, you. And these are wine-pouring muscles.
I was a rower on Pericles' ship where he took pity on me. Now I pour wine for people who question my word. And his.
I wasn't questioning. I... Perhaps one drink.
Why don't you just apologize to Sophocles?
It's he who should apologize to you.
Sophocles is a friend, and one good friend is worth an entire family. He just needs time to recover from his outburst.
Let's conjure Dionysos, shall we?
This is pure swill.
Amateur. In my day, this would be considered nectar of the gods. Another round!
Pericles has invited all of you here for some reason.
Either we dine here and praise Pericles, or we dine with Cleon. But Cleon has all the charm of a typical politician. A horrible voice, bad breathing, and vulgar manners.
Ready for more?
I can hardly stomach this pig's piss.
I could outdrink both of you with one hand. Let's have some more.
You ready for another?
This wine is terrible.
You, I like you. Who brought you here?
I brought myself. I'm on the trail of a woman who fled Sparta a long time ago.
Fled? Why?
She lost two children. She had no choice.
She fled to heal a broken heart. Euripides, write her into a play.
I've heard Spartan mothers go to a sanctuary in Argolis to beg Asclepios for his divine pity. I should know, it's my home.
After what she went through, I'm not sure she'd trust priests.
Then she sought my friend, Hippocrates. He's a physician, best of the best. He still keeps his office in Argos. If she went to him for help, there's no doubt he'd have given it.
I love getting drunk and singing. Come back if you want to sing with me.
I'll think about it.
How's Euripides? Drunk, I hope.
You can stop hiding in here. Euripides won't notice you coming out. He won't notice anything.
Hiding? Heed this. War has come to Athens. First they take our homes, then they take our heads. I intend to be found with at least my dignity intact. Or what's left of it anyway. If you see Pericles, tell him I said thank you for another colorful evening.